ജനുവരി
Children going to their school is a beginning of the most promising story for any society. These children walking on cement concrete road to reach their school is telling not only a promising but also a proud story for the people of Kadahalli GP of Karnataka. These steps on the cement concrete road are reverberating the success of Gram Vikas Yojana and Chief Minister Grama Vikas Yojana towards paving the path of progress across Karnataka. The CC road is one among 13 similar roads constructed in the Gram Panchayat.
You can't imagine the kind of benefit people staying over here have got because of this road. Earlier, during rainy season, it used to be full of puddles, mosquitoes and whatnot. But now, there is no puddle and drainage system is so good that water cannot stay even for a second over here. It is such a great feeling.
Now, every hamlet of the Gram Panchayat is free from waterlogging, mosquitoes breeding or unhygienic condition. It is but natural that people are happy. Happiness is one of the very subtle indicators of comprehensive development. Rural development schemes like MNREGA, having its thrust on employment generation, many a times leave some critical gaps in the implementation of a project. In Nagaura GP, the construction of CC road and CC drainage was difficult to construct in accordance to guidelines of MNREGA, about 40% of project cost allocation for the materials. Thankfully, the Gram Panchayat functionaries have the additional resources under Gram Vikas Yojana. With vision, commitment and compassion in policy making, as well as planning through Gram Vikas Yojana, and later on Chief Minister Gram Vikas Yojana, Karnataka has shown the way to bridge the critical gaps in rural development funding towards sustainable and comprehensive development of villages. Honorable Chief Minister Sri Siddaramaiah had announced in his budget speech of 2014-15 this path-breaking scheme Gram Vikas Yojana for the comprehensive development of 1,000 villages selected by MLAs of all the 189 assembly constituencies of Karnataka. And 750 crore rupees was earmarked for the duration of 3 years. Under the scheme, approval from government has been given to 939 villages from 189 legislative assembly constituencies and a total expenditure of 678.85 crore rupees has been incurred towards completing the developmental projects undertaken in these villages. Extending the scheme and renaming it as Chief Minister Gram Vikas Yojana, in year 2017-18, budget with the provision of 1,000 crore, within 2 years' time, the development of another 1,000 villages were planned with a unit cost of 1 crore rupees for each village. During 2017-18, under Chief Minister Gram Vikas Yojana, 875 villages have been selected and 198 crore rupees was released to take up various projects. The selection of GPs was done by MLAs in each of the assembly constituencies. The popularity of the scheme among the masses is felt by the people's representatives as well.
This Yojana includes the RCC, road, drainage, water supply, Anganwadi, shalas, school buildings, temple construction. All the facilities what we got in the urban area should be given to the rural area peoples. This is introduced in the villages where more than 50% SC, ST and backward class and minorities peoples are staying. Gradually, it will be increased to all the villages in Karnataka.
Both the schemes are dedicated to achieve the comprehensive rural development through 21 points program, including construction of roads and drainage, development of educational, cultural and sporting environment, promotion of public sanitation through construction of community toilets, revival of religious spots, construction of cow pen, better facilities at community institutions like Anganbadi, etc.
See, Gram Vikas Yojana is a very special and unique program for our Gram Panchayat. We know that though we have 6,024 Gram Panchayats and 30,000 and odd villages in Karnataka, we will not be able to improve everything at a time. So what we did that wherever the population is more than 3,000, we have taken those villages and converting into, model villages. And so that its development of infrastructure is totally complete and it becomes economically viable model for development and then also progress in the journey of this thing where we want to give them the best facilities as in the urban areas.
The preparation and approval of annual action plan under the scheme was done as per the guidelines.
Under the Gram Vikas Yojana, the planning is first being done at the village level. Once it is being finalized, it is being sent to the block where it is discussed thoroughly. And then it is being sent to the district level. And only at the district level, plan is given a solid shape.
The schemes, with its innate character of comprehensiveness and innovations, turned ward meetings and Gram Sabhas into the platform of creative thinking and active participation of villagers during the process of charting the outlines of Gram Vikas.
In Gram Vikas and Mukhyamantri Gram Vikas, it gives a more accountable and a transparency to the Gram Panchayats. If it is really accountable to the peoples, then only it is the scheme will be successfully implemented. Otherwise, we are not going to get a good result out of it. So that's why the government is releases to the directly to the Gram Panchayats the amount. Then it gives the schemes will be formulated and implemented in the presence of the peoples and the participation of the peoples.
50% of the allocated fund under the scheme was available for the construction of CC roads, pakka drainage and stone slab on drainage to improve the sanitation status in the selected villages. The improved intra-village connectivity has supported economic activities.
First, during rainy season, it's very useful for us. It was so difficult to go anywhere, but after having this CC road, life has changed a lot.
Facilitated education of children and helped access to the religious places. 6% of the allocated fund under the scheme is earmarked for the renovation or new construction of places of faith and worship. In many places, this helped the village community to undertake the long pending renovation work at the earliest.
What you see today is because of 4.5 lakh of rupees given under the Gram Vikas Yojana to this mosque. I feel very thankful to the government of providing us this support.
Other than spiritual enlightenment of the village communities, the scheme is also very effective in addressing the requirement of well-lit streets in the villages. Using environment-friendly and sustainable solar streetlight and LED bulbs by utilizing 3% of allocated fund, the scheme is making the villages safer and more secure.
This solar plates provide so much help for all of us. Here now, even in the night, we don't have any problems. Kids do not feel any problem and it has become very comfortable for us.
For a village to be safe from diseases, proper management of garbage is essential. Gram Vikas Yojana has earmarked 10% of the allocated fund for the establishment of modern and scientific garbage pit or garbage treatment units. Several Gram Panchayats, similar to Kudur GP, managing its garbage by burning and dumping it in a landfill, are now enthusiastic to set up proper solid waste recycling unit.
We go door to door to collect the wastage from every household and after that we carry it on a truck or any vehicle to this place and dump. Later on, we are planning to have a segregation unit where we segregate all the wastage and use it in a commercial manner as well.
If garbage treatment units make our environment healthy, then sports-related facilities keeps out young generation healthy. Rural sportsperson of Karnataka do not lack in talent or passion. And with adequate facilities, they can make their mark in sports world easily. This precisely is the purpose to earmark 12% of allotted fund for the development of sport facilities in villages. Today, flood-lit ground, gyms, etc. are becoming realities in thousands of villages. A healthy body is the abode of a healthy mind. Appreciating the importance of reading habit, a progressive village must provide its resident comfortable reading environment of a library having good books.
Whenever I need a dictionary or I need books, before exam I come here and it is very useful for us because we get all the books in this library which help us to perform well in
exams.
Earlier it was difficult to get newspaper in our village, but now whenever we feel like reading newspaper or any other books, we come here and spend our time fretfully and it has become a great meeting place for all of us as well.
While towns and cities have good quality libraries with state-of-the-art facilities, sadly, most of the village libraries are not very spacious ones.
Public are using the library as much as possible for their good habits and for their knowledge improvement. And every facilities are very good for the library, but the library is very short, very small in the space. So from the Gram Vikas Yojana, the government is providing the construction as a much more space building. So after the construction, we are going to use the facilities.
Realizing this fact that every village needs a thriving place for intellectual engagements, the construction of library or meeting hall or auditorium, etc., is listed as the work to be undertaken under the scheme, and 12% of allocated fund is put aside for this purpose.
Under the Gram Vikas Yojana, this big building is constructed which would also host a library. It would be great for the people of the area.
An upcoming big library using this fund gives the book Loving People of Asoluru Gram Panchayat a reason to rejoice. Across Karnataka, people living in thousands of villages are having their own reason to rejoice.
Earlier, this temple was not in a good shape. Even the road connecting this temple to the people was in a very bad shape. Under the Gram Vikas Yojana, this temple has been renovated and the road has also been relaid. It has come as a great boom for all villagers.
This lady is filling water in her pitcher without facing any inconvenience like waterlogging, slippery surface or mud around. These are washing clothes and all the water is getting drained out so effectively. Inside the village, all roads are all weather roads and moving inside the village is becoming very comfortable. Walking on mud-free roads, even the livestock in these villages are healthy and safe from the erstwhile prevalent foot infections. Guided by the vision of comprehensive development, the comfort of commuting is not restricted to intra-village movement only. Addressing the critical gap in connectivity scheme from the habitation with smaller population, Namma Grama Namma Raste Yojana is facilitating connectivity till the doorstep of village community, literally meaning Our Village, Our Road scheme. NGNRY has fulfilled the long-cherished dream of people living in inaccessible villages or hamlets of marginalized communities like Bapuji Colony. Chikka Virayana Doddi village of around 150 households comes under Oyambali Gram Panchayat. This village is just 888 meter uphill to a major road called Kanakpura Sangama Road, which connects the block headquarters to a major tourism destination confluence of River Kaveri and River Arkavati. Under NGNRY, Phase 4, this road has been taken for the upgradation and most certainly it will upgrade the ways of living and livelihoods for these 150 households.
Under Namma Grama Namma Yojana, this road has been constructed earlier. There was hardly any traffic on this road, but now the traffic has improved considerably and that is why I am constructing a shop over here. It would give a meaningful employment to me.
So this actually this road was started 3 months back and we are about to complete this road in another 1 month probably. After 5 years we go for the resurfacing of the road. There are 10 other roads taken in NGNRY phase 4. We are about to complete that within 4 to 5 months.
The road once ready will look like this road connecting Heganur village and Ramanayaka Dodi village of the Uyambali Gram Panchayat completed under phase 3. Good quality roads with the provision to maintenance for long period can undeniably lay the path of progress. Comprehensive development of villages added with last step all-weather connectivity would certainly help rural people to start their journey towards their dreams.